Do you ever look at someone and wonder what is going on inside their head?
Blood for the blood god! Blood for the blood god! Blood for the blood god!
Hello, everyone. It's Seth, probably better known as Seth Rada Live, and it's time for another edition of Budget Magic. And this week, we are teaching our opponent a lesson in Modern with a deck called Demonic Learning, backing up some learn lesson stuff with Demon Adeske and Awaken the Blood Avatar. Is the learn lesson package actually good enough for Modern? Let's talk about the deck, jump into some games, and find out. All right, so here is our Demonic Learning deck, and our plan is to hopefully get either Demon Adeske or Awaken the Blood Avatar on the battlefield as quickly as possible. Awaken the Blood Avatar, backside of Exis. We can't even cast Exis, so we're just going to ignore that part of the card for now. But Demon and Awaken the Blood Avatar both reward us for sacking creatures by getting cheaper. Demon Adeske, sack 3 black creatures, pay 6 life, we can cast it for free. So this means we can potentially have a Demon Adeske on the battlefield on turn 2. Awaken the Blood Avatar takes an extra turn, but on turn 3, we can sack 3 creatures and pay 2 mana and get the big avatar that makes our opponent sacrifices something and also deals some direct damage when it attacks. So how are we getting these cards on the battlefield quickly? And step one is a bunch of one drops. We have Bloodsoaked Champion, Dread Wanderer, Gutter Bones. All one drops that come back from the graveyard. Eyetwitch, when it dies, gets to tutor a lesson from our sideboard. But if you look at the math on these cards, if we play a one drop on turn one, two more on turn two, that means we can immediately on turn two sacrifice everything, get a Demon Adeske, or on turn three sacrifice everything and get an Awaken the Blood Avatar token. And that's kind of the main goal of our deck, putting our opponent to the test with this massive threat on turn 2, on turn 3, hoping we can ride it to victory. We also have Lazatep Reaver, which is essentially 2 one drops in 1 because it makes the mass token, so it can replace the 2 one drops on turn 2, which we were talking about, like a one drop into Lazatep Reaver, still enough creatures to get a Demon at Death Gate, still enough creatures to sack to Awaken the Blood Avatar. Then we have our Learn Lesson package, and it might look a little bit strange, but Eyetwitch, really good in our one drop plan. Hunt for Specimens can tutor a lesson out of our sideboard and puts a body to the battlefield. Poet's Quill may be the weirdest of the bunch, but remember, Demon Adeske makes us lose 6 life, and it gives us this massive flyer, so against aggro, we can theoretically get our Poet's Quill out our Demon Adeske and start gaining back 10 life a turn to swing the race in our favor. As far as our sideboard, here's our lesson package. We do have Dresses, Angrath Rampage, Nile Spellbombs is non-lesson cards, but we got a bunch of Pest Summonings, which works really well with our plan. We can tutor it up when we sack our Eyetwitch or cast our Hunt for Specimens, and Pest Summonings is going to help us get our second demon or second avatar on the battlefield. Necrotic Fumes for removal, start from scratch, yeah, just kind of a catch-all to deal with artifacts. Mana base wise, pretty typical budget stuff, as many dual lands as we can, a bunch of swamps. The mana is a bit clunky, but dual lands are expensive, so this is the best we could do considering the budget restrictions. And that is Demonic Learning for Modern. Is Learning Lesson actually good enough for the format? How good is a plan? Can Awaken the Blood Avatar work in a format with Fatal Push, which is one of the big risks? How good is Eyetwitch? Let's jump into some games and find out. Thanks for watching. I hope you all enjoy it, and I will talk to you soon. Need some new Modern Horizons cards? Well, you can pre-order them from our sponsor, Card Kingdom, by heading over to cardkingdom.com. All right, budget magic time. We are heading to Modern this week for a hand that we like. This is a turn 3 Blood Avatar hand, if nothing goes horribly wrong. Unfortunately, Smolding Marsh is going to come into play and tap, but turn 1... probably Eyetwitch, double Bloodsoaked Champion into Awaken the Blood Avatar and cross our fingers, hope that that's enough to win the game. I mean, that's what our deck's trying to do. This is what the deck wants to do, either with Awaken the Blood Avatar or Demon Adeske, which probably a little better, but still, both are pretty sweet. We're trying to get those on turn 2 or turn 3, and trusting that they will lead us to victory. Thought Seize would be obnoxious. I guess removal spells on our one drops would be obnoxious, but who in Modern is going to kill an Eyetwitch? Who views this as a legitimate threat that is going to wreck them? I guess a counter would also be annoying. Like if we sack our board in well, Forbidden Ruins, reveal the swamp, play a Eyetwitch. Go. Put it. Tap land. Ugh. Those are colors that could have Thought Seize. Well, play the land, play a Bloodsoaked Champion. Hit ya. Well, let's see what our opponent has. Our dream is they play like a Tarmogoyf or something. Ooh. Since our opponent's not tapping down, I think we might actually wait. Because a single fatal push... oh my god. All right, just kidding. They could have Assassin's Trophy. All right, go to combat. Attack. Hit ya. Opponent cracks. Gets a swamp. All right, there's a fatal push. Sure. Well, play Smoldering Marsh. Play Lazatep Reaver. Sack, sack, sack. Demon at Death Gate. Get a Pest Summonings. Pass the turn. All right. We can beat a Liliana, Assassin's Trophy, or Maelstrom Pulse would be a problem. And then we can use some combination of Pest Summoning plus Blood Soak Champions to get down our Avatar next. Probably going to take us two more turns if our opponent's still alive, but we do have a backup plan if this goes wrong. Opponent, Swamp. All right, there's a Liliana. Sure. Takes it down. We will sack Lazatep Reaver. Well, 1, 2, 3 Pest Summonings. Yeah, play the tap land. Go to combat. 9 our opponent. Oh, it's going to be hilarious if these Pest Summonings are essential to us winning this game. An opponent scoops it up. All right, well, that went according to plan, I would say. Opponent's playing Jund. What do we want against Jund? So we can go down Poet's Quill. I don't think Lifelink is going to be super helpful. Go down Poet's Quill. Go up Dresses. Go down... That went excellent. Demon Death Gate's a card, if you can get it down quickly enough. Actually, maybe we don't go heavy on Dresses. So the good news is, like, let's say our opponent picks apart our hand with discard and takes our big payoffs. Our recursive one drop seems decent. Let's bring in the Rampages to have more creature removal. You know what? Let's not Duress. Forget the Duress plan. I mean, I think our backup plan, if this goes wrong, is just to play one drops and try to get there with one drops, which seems possible. Well, this hand's okay. A little bit clunky thanks to the amount of tap lands, but about it. Inquisition of Kozlek. Well, they're not taking the demon, I tell you that. I guess they take a Reaver or the Village Rites? I mean, we're playing a tap... Wow, takes a Blood Soak Champion. Interesting. Well, we're playing a tap land on turn one, passing the turn. This does turn on our Dragon Skull Summits, at least. Overgrown Tomb tapped. About it. Passing. Well, Dragon Skull Summit and a... Huh. Yeah, let's just land as a Tap Reaver. If our opponent wants to spend a removal spell on half of it, I think we're okay with that. Opponent. Swamp. And passes. Well, play Dragon Skull Summit. Go to combat. We're not just going to rush out the Demon of Death Gate here. I think it's too likely that our opponent has an answer. So go attacking. Get back Blood Soak Champion. Play a Gutter Bones. Pass the turn. We can be patient. I mean, we actually kind of have a lot of power on the battlefield. I assume our opponent's expecting us to play the demon and leaving up removal to deal with the demon. So we're just going to try to juke around that by not playing the demon and instead beating our opponent down with random dorks. You know, I actually think we just discard the demon. Do we discard the demon? Well, let's discard a Village Rites. Opponent. I mean, we have 5 power, most of it recursive on the battlefield. That seems reasonable. Opponent, Swamp, and Bloodbraid Elf into a Kroxa. All right. We will discard Lazatep Reaver. That Kroxa is annoying. About it. Passes. You know what? We're going to go for this. Sack, sack, sack. Awaken the Blood Avatar. Make you sack. Hit ya for 6. And if our opponent has removal, at least we can Village Rites. We're going to need to find some more dorks to start getting back our one drops. Opponent. Ooh, Ashiok. That's actually pretty obnoxious. And a Thought Seize. Well, all right. I mean, I guess the good news is this means our Blood Avatar is living. The bad news is it means our opponent's kind of getting us with Ashiok. Yeah. Well, the demon's not looking great at the moment. If our opponent can answer the Avatar, we draw a Fatal Push. Well, okay. Hit ya. Ignore the Ashiok. Opponent, down to 4. Can we close it out, or do they have removal? Liliana. All right. And we will scoop it up. Sure. Well, that game, our opponent had enough answers to survive, unfortunately. Well, we'll run it back. Kind of surprised about bringing in Ashiok. I mean, I guess it helps against our recursive one-drops, but... I don't know, maybe we were too conservative. Maybe we should just slam the demon and hoped for the best. I feel like Jund is, there's a lot of matchups where that's awesome, but I feel like Jund is one of the matchups where they just have so much real removal that going all in on the demon feels pretty risky. Well, we got one drops for days. No big payoff at the moment, but hopefully that's fine. Play a swamp and a gut of bones. Go. Fortunately, not going to be able to double one drop next turn because of Smoldering Marsh. Opponent tapland and passes. I don't go to combat. Hit ya. Play a Dreadwander. Play a budget land. Pass the turn. Yeah, that is kind of annoying. We're doing the best we can considering the budget restrictions as far as mana, but this is going to happen on occasion. Opponent Inquisition takes the Gutta Bones, Verdant Catacombs, and passes. More tap lands. Well, go to combat. Attack ya. We will Eyetwitch and Blood Soak Champion and pass. We're not going to play the Foreboding Ruins because we need a buffer for discard, I think. Maybe that's wrong. Opponent gets a tap land. Like, Liliana Takedown doesn't do anything. We want to try to hold on to this Fatal Push because if our opponent plays like a Tarmogoyf or something, we want to be able to answer it and keep attacking. Opponent, tap land, passes. Well, okay, we will Foreboding Ruins, reveal a swamp, go to combat, attack you. All right, bolts a Dreadwander, Fatal Pushes a Gutter Bones. All right, so opponent's got the removal for days, drops to 10. Well, we'll get back a Gutter Bones, replay a Gutter Bones, pass the turn. Opponent, Thought Seizes. All right, so Thought Seize plus try to get a blocker going, I guess. Wooded Foothills cracks it. Only two cards in hand. That is not a lot of cards. And our opponent's also down to 5. Oh, that's game. We got him. Go-go one drops. We got the GGs. Okay. Well, apparently, poor Judd. Apparently, Judd cannot beat Lessons. If we don't win another match for the rest of this episode, at least we learned that modern Jund cannot be an Eyetwitch. Poor Jund. Poor Jund. The meme lives. Well, that was sweet. All right. Budget magic time. We are teaching our modern opponents a lesson this week with Awaken the Blood Avatar. And let's see what this hand looks like. Okay. I mean, I guess we'll keep this. Sand's more okay than great, but we got some card draw. We're basically missing a big payoff. We're up against Yarion, which could mean a bunch of things. Our mana is not the worst, but also not great. All right, opponent's playing some sort of control deck by the looks. Another Village Rites. Well, Foreboding Ruins, reveal the swamp, play a Blood Soak Champion. Pass the turn. Blue White Tron, interesting. Have not seen Blue White Tron in a while. Opponent bounces. Boo. Well, we will play a swamp. We will play Lazat Upreaver past the turn. Ugh. Netherland is less than optimal, I would say. Opponent. Yeah, I don't know if we can easily beat Tron. A lot of our sideboard is dedicated to lessons. Maybe we are the one learning the lesson this match. We'll see. I mean, maybe they won't assemble Tron. They are blue-white Tron. Would have been nice if we could have bounced the Blood Soak Champion. Field of Ruin, not super concerned about that. Gets the Yarion. Opponent passes. Well, we will play a Swamp. We will play Blood Soak Champion. We will go to combat. Attack. Hit ya. And we're probably going to have to play Dreadwander. I was wondering if we should try to leave up double Village Rites in case there's a Wrath, but, I mean, our opponent's going to win the late game, so I think we just got to go pedal to the metal. Opponent, Flooded Strand, and passes. Whew. Well, play a land, go to combat, attack. I think we got to wait, hit ya. Village Rites, Blood Soak Champion. Get back, Blood Soak Champion. Pass the turn. Opponent's down to 11, gets a land. Okay. Gifstrod! If this is Elishorn on Burial Rites, then we're dead. Elishorn on Burial Rites. All right. Well, fair enough. We did not build with this combo in mind, so yeah. I mean, you got us. We'll bring in Duress. We'll bring in Nile Spell Bombs. We'll go down Poet's Quills. We will go down fatal pushes and run it like that. Oh, we got off to a decent start, too. The problem is... Hi. Alistair on burial rights. That's not good for us. I don't know. Okay, I will say. If you're playing a combo deck where your goal is to resolve Gifts Ungiven to win the game, and you're trying to assemble Tron, I'm not 100% sure about the wisdom of being 80 cards. I mean, I know Yarion is busted, but I kind of think that would be the exact sort of deck you would not want to have 80 cards, but I mean, maybe it can still be consistent. It's definitely interesting, unique. Maybe we should just X this. Although, I guess, like... So, the problem there is, you might be thinking, oh, you can just awaken the Blood Avatar and get rid of the Alishnorn. No. All of our things are going to be dead, so this is going to cost 8 mana, and there's no way we're getting to 8 mana. Even with our Flood out there, there's no way we're getting to 8 mana. Not in a million billion years. Alright, we get to play first. One tap land, no payoffs. Alright, we'll mulligan. Well, two tap lands. I guess that's a step in the right direction. We will keep... I guess we're putting X's to the bottom of this hand. Oh, tap lands. Opponent has been doing some very aggressive mulliganing. I mean, I guess that's what happens when you're an 80 card combo deck sometimes. I mean, they aggressively mulliganed in game one and it worked out for them. One weird thing I've noticed is the prices of dual lands seem to be increasing. Even the bad dual lands. Like, it's getting harder and harder to build a functional modern budget mana base. Well, the swamp is good. That actually helps quite a bit. We will duress you. Ramp, Cyclonic Rift, Gifts Ungiven. Well, we'll take the gifts. Play a Gutter Bones. Pass the turn. Alright. We could use more threats. That would be helpful. We got the reanimation plan solved for the moment, though. We can fizzle a Cyclonic Rift if our opponent goes for it with Village Rites. Opponent plays the Mana Rock. Even more lands. Well, Dragon Skull Summit. Play Nile Spellbomb. We're going to need a faster clock. I don't think just a Gutter Bones is necessarily going to get their hit yet down to 17. Opponent. Because, I mean, eventually our opponent will just cast big things. Expedition map. Sure. Cracks it. Are we getting Tron Land 1? I guess next turn, if we don't draw anything, we can Gutter Bones. Gutter Bones, attack, sack, draw, etc., etc. Opponent gets a Blast Zone. Actually pretty good against our deck. Yeah, let's untap. Oh my god. Alright, the Flood. The Flood is on. Get in with the Gutter Bones. Hit ya. Village Right. Sack Gutter Bones. Draw a couple cards. Get back Gutter Bones. Replay Gutter Bones. Pass the turn. Well, we're up to 5 lands. About it. Gets Yarion. Well, go to combat. Attack ya. Hit ya. Down to 13. Blood Soak Champion. Smoldering Marsh. Pass the turn. Thought not... Wow. Opponent's got a little bit of everything. Sure. Why not? Well, I mean, I think we're probably dead now unless we top deck something. Opponent takes our one drop. Well, we're going to sack Nile Spellbomb and draw a card because we could really use some action. Duress, not super helpful. Untap. Land number 6. That is a lot. Cyclonic Rift, Snapcaster, Elishnorn in hand. We'll play the Swamp, go to combat, attack. Opponent. Yeah, this is not working out. Opponent blocks the Gutter Bones. Oh, we will get back Gutter Bones. We will replay Gutter Bones. We will play Nile Spellbomb. We will pass the turn. Yeah, this is a little awkward. Opponent, combat. Passes. We draw. Another Gutter Bones. Really good at drawing Gutter Bones. Go attacking. Opponent. Wow. Finds path to exile. Oh, no. That's, yeah, I think they got us now. That is a good top deck. Opponent blocks. I mean, yeah. I think we're giving up stage of this game. Dreadwander. Because if we play stuff, it gets blast zoned. Yeah, I mean, one drop, go. Yeah, this is not worked out the way we were hoping. Oh, boot it. Well, I guess that's another way that you can make a 80 card combo deck work is if you just play a whole bunch of really busted cards. Then I guess it doesn't matter what you draw, you just trust that the raw power level is going to work out. Opponent. Little pump fake. Goes attacking. Hits us down to 16. Well, if we had known our opponent was... Yeah, I don't even know. Maybe we would have played differently if we had known... Or sideboarded differently if we'd known our opponent was... I don't know. Blue, white, 80 card. Oh my god, that's another land. We are breaking records. Duress, I don't think does anything. It's Elishnorn and Snapcaster. Yeah, all right. Well, that did not work in like 20 different ways. All right, budget magic time. We are learning our opponent's... So what we want to see? This is what we want to see. I mean, if nothing goes wrong, one drop, double one drop, Demon to Escape, odd turn two. Hopefully that makes you die. Depends a little bit on the matchup, but I mean, this is exactly what we want our hands to look like. So we have a demon instead of Blood Avatar, but that's fine. Plus we get to do a little bit of learning. Opponent, a color that theoretically has actual removal. Awkward. Path to Exile is pretty good against us. Thought Seize would be the blowout. Four lands, more than we would prefer. Hollowed Fountain, tapped. About it. Passes. I'm honestly not sure if we go for it or not. Well, we're going to play Dragon Skull Summit. Go to combat, attack you. Opponent has Fatal Push. All right, staying alive. Well, we will Blood Soak Champion. We will Gutter Bones. We will pass the turn. Now that does slow us down by a turn. Opponent. Snow-covered island. This might be a matchup where our payoffs are not as good. Opponent. Passes. Well, go to combat. Attack you. Snapcaster. Fatal push. All right. Opponent. Fatal pushes again. Well, you know what? I think we play the demon and see what happens. Play land. Play Eyetwitch. Play Blood Soak Champion. Demon at Deskgate. Sack, sack, sack. Hope for the best. Eyetwitch. We'll get us a Pest Summonings. All right. How much removal can our opponent have? The problem is Teferi blows us out hardcore. This is probably about the single worst matchup for the Demon of Deathgate plan. Opponent passes. We go to combat. We attack. Oh, opponent takes it. Okay. Well, Swamp. Blood Soak Champion. Blood-soaked champion. Pass the turn. I mean, our opponent is to the point where they're dead on board if they cannot deal with this demon. That is a power demon. Opponent, all right. All about them fatal pushes. Sure. Untaps. Can they find a real answer? I guess thanks to Pest Summoning. Wow, opponent scoops it up. Okay. Okay, okay. That was good. That was good. Well, we will bring in Derezes for sure. We will go down a couple of fatal pushes. Huh. A couple of Fatal Pushes and a Poet's Quill. We'll bring in Angrass Rampage for a Poet's Quill. Poet's Quill just doesn't seem good against control. Could also bring in the Spell Bombs. You know what? I think, sadly, because we've seen these Fatal Pushes, I think we're actually going to trim an Xyz. It's just too easy for Awaken the Blood Avatar to get got by a Fatal Push. That is the drawback. Demon dodges Fatal Push for days, as we saw in game one. Awaken the Blood Avatar, conveniently for our Fatal Pushing opponents, zero CMC. Keep. Sounds incredibly bad. All right, this is better-ish. We'll put Fatal Push to the bottom. All right, so no payoff, but we can learn. Watery Grave untapped, and Thossies, Relic, sure. Well, we actually don't have a hand that cares too much about the graveyard. We'll play a land, play Eyetwitch. We don't have a payoff at the moment, but we got random dorks we can try to beat down with. Flooded Strand for our opponent. Cracks it. Down to 17. This Esper mana base is hurting our opponent a smidge. Godless Shrine. Whew. All right, opponent's down to 15 before we even get to attack. Tide Hollow Sculler. Well, maybe we shouldn't have put that to the bottom. About it. Was not expecting Tide Hollow Sculler, honestly. Well, go Eyetwitches. Prove your worth in Modern, little Eyebat. Opponent takes the immediate learning. Ooh, I don't know if we want a demon. It's what our deck is here to do, but I'm also a little worried about how blown out we could get. Let's wait. Let's hit you with the Eyetwitch. Play a Swamp. Play an Eyetwitch. Play Nile Spellbomb. Pass the turn. Maybe we can just go all the way with Eyetwitches. Oh, it's just such a risky matchup to go in on the Demon of Deathgate. It would be nice if we could draw duress first. If we can draw duress, that makes it much easier. Opponent, I'm going to get with Tide Hollow. Sure. No blocks. Down to 18. Yeah, duress would be sweet to just know if the coast is clear. Fatal pushes in Eyetwitch. That's fine. Okay, that doesn't actually fizzle it, but sure, we will get a Pest Summonings. We do need a land for it, though. Oh, there's the duress. All right, so I think what we do is Lazatep Reaver, go to combat, hit ya. So what we want to do here, in a perfect world, is duress, make sure there's not a hard answer to Demon and Deskgate, and then Demon and Deskgate win in two attacks. That's what we're trying to set up. Marsh Flats, another relic, sure. One more land would be fine, too. Not Foreboding Ruins. Oh, my God. No Snarls, please. Opponent passes. Oh, there's the land. So, go to combat. Get in with the Eyetwitch. Hit ya. Dragon Skull Summit. Duress you. Cryptic Snapcaster Nullifier. Oh! Are we doing it? Are we doing it? I think we are. Well, take the Cryptic. Yeah, I mean, boom. Sack all of you. Do a bit of learning. Well, we'll see. Does our opponent find an answer? They do not have one in hand. We will take a Pest Summonings. Get a 9/9 Flying Trample. Pass the turn. Opponent needs to top deck. Cracks. Down to 11. Watery Grave. Tapped. Well, we shall see. Can our opponent top deck a way to deal with the demon in the next two turns? They get at least one redraw, probably two redraws if they're desperate. We do have the graveyard covered. All right, opponent cracks. Well, let's see if they find it. About it. Relic. Another redraw. Cracks it. Desperately. Looking for a path. Do they find a path? Land. Well, we know all except one card in our opponent's hand. About it. Passes. We will untap. Go to combat. Attack you with the demon. Even just this hits big. Opponent goes to two. Play a swamp. Pest Summonings. All right. Well, opponent gets one more draw at it. Do they find the demon answer? They do not. Whew. Well, that's the power of the deck. All the dual lands and snapcasters and control pieces in the world. Can't beat early 9/9, apparently. Sweet. All right. Whew. Budget magic time. We are trying to awaken the blood avatar. Also learning. And teaching our opponent lessons in Modern of all places. I do not know what to do with this hand. If we draw one drop, we have turn two Demon of Deskgate. We do have a lot of one drops in our deck. We could probably calculate it, honestly. We have 16 one drops. Out of 53 cards left in our deck, 16 one drops. One draw, need to hit one. Odds are 30%. 30% of the time it works every time? Yeah, we're gonna keep it. I mean, of course, we could also just get Thought Seized or something, and then we get Super Blunt. Waste. Okay. One drop, please? Yeah, that's one drop. All right. Well, Bloodsuck Champion, go. Well, so our opponent appears to be Eldrazi Tron, which should mean they can't easily answer Demon of Death. Wow. Okay. Well, Demons Ahoy. One drop's getting countered forever. Thankfully, we can play Dragon Skull Summit. We can play a Lazatep Reaver. We can hit our opponent for two to put him to 18. Play a 9/9. Ooh. Well, we'll see. We'll see if it's enough. Blood soak you. I mean, if they can answer the demon, then they win. It's as simple as that. If they answer the demon, we're not going to be able to recover with basically our entire deck getting got by Chalice of the Void. On the other hand, if they cannot answer the demon in two turns, we win. Matter Reshaper. That doesn't do it. So our opponent has one turn to draw a demon answer. We will go to combat. We will attack you. We will hit you. Down to 9. Bloodsoak Champion. Why not? Swamp. And I guess we actually cast Dreadwanderer. It gets countered, but it's better in the graveyard because we can potentially return it to the battlefield. I guess that's her way around Chalice, is get stuff countered and try to put it into play. All right, and opponent cannot answer the 9/9, and not bad at all. Well, I mean, that is the plan. That's what we're trying to do. So I think we definitely bring an Ingress Rampage. Because we do need to be able to answer Chalice of the Void. That is important to our game plan. I guess we just cut Poet's Quill. I don't think Lifelink is really gonna matter. And try to do that again. that was sweet. Tap lands for days, but we'll keep. Drawing a swamp would be actually our best possible draw here. But we do have an answer to Chalice, which is nice. All right, opponent, doing the Tron Mulligans. We draw a Fatal Push. Well, Foreboding Ruins, tapped, go. Yeah, going to be a little bit of a slow start thanks to, budget mana. It happens on a... Oh, no. Did they just mulligan into Tron? We don't actually have a way to stop Tron if they did. Well, Bloodsoak Champion, Dragon Skull Summit. Oh, nothing makes me a little tilty like Eldrazi Tron having Tron. All right, it's a waste. That's better than actual Tron. Opponent passes. Land, maybe? Eyetwitch will go to combat. We will hit you. If opponent goes to kill it, yeah, we will Village Rites to try to draw land. Well, it's a tap land, but it is a land. We will play a Gutter Bones. Dragon Skull Summit tapped, yeah. Having to play all these tap lands might actually end up costing us this game, hilariously. Opponent thought not. Like, 99% sure they're taking Exis. We can answer this, though. We can Eyetwitch, sack Eyetwitch to Village Rites. Yeah, it takes Exis. Then we draw Demon. Huh. Well, we have a new plan. Our new plan is play a Gutter Bones, play a Eyetwitch, Demon of Deathgate, sack it all, learn for a start from scratch, and then Fatal Push, Thought Not Seer. That was not a bad turn. And we even have an answer in case our opponent can get an Ensnaring Bridge. Seagate Wreckage, opponent, passes. Oh, these Dragon Skull Summits. Well, attack with a demon, hit ya. Get back a Bloodsoak Champion, tap land, go. Oh, these tap lads. Opponent taps. Can you beat a demon? Expedition map. Wow. All right. Expedition map does let our opponent get Tron. So if they have Karn, then they can theoretically win. That is something. All right, Tron. Walking Ballista. Well, that doesn't just kill us, though. Opponent passing. We untap. Well, sack a creature. Village Rites. Draw some cards. Opponent pings us. Opponent pings us. Well, there's our lands. Play the land, go to combat, hit you to one. Get back Bloodsoak Champion, or hit you to two. Virtual one things to start from scratch. All right. Well, this is it, opponent. Find your answer if you can. Untaps two cards in hand. Tron on the battlefield, and we got the GGs. All right, opponent. Pump fakes and scoops it up, and well... So, hilariously, we haven't done a whole lot with our avatar, honestly, but maybe even more hilarious, being able to learn cards from our sideboard has actually sort of been relevant in Modern, surprisingly. Well, sweet, sweet. All right, budget magic time. We are learning our opponent some lessons in Modern, and you know what, I think we keep this. We're missing the payoff, unfortunately. We would love to find Awaken the Blood Avatar or a demon. We also have our sort of clunky mana. We play Dread Wonder on turn one. Turn two, though, looking like it's gonna be a tap land and nothing. Actually, if our opponent plays something, we can Fatal Push. That's good. All right, Clever Lumomancer, that is worth killing for sure. Well, this might finally be the matchup for Poet Squill to be good. It seems like it could be good against aggro. Like, that's idea, is against a deck that can deal a bunch of damage. We can just lifelink it up and go to town. Would still love to find a demon. Opponent, Inspiring Vantage. And Niv-Magus Elemental. And, ooh, okay, another Niv-Magus. That's frightening. Demon. More tap lands. We will. You know, we're going to attack. If our opponent has an instant speed spell and blows us out, then we will accept it. They can, like, mutagenic growth and eat it. All right, looks like that's the plan. So opponent blocks. So I assume mutagenic growth or gut shot. Eat it, grow the dork, eat our Dread Wanderer. Yeah, fair enough. So we lose Dread Wanderer for now. We will play a Lazatep Reaver. Do a little amassing. Play a Snarl. Not yet called a Snarl, but definitely a Snarl. Opponent. Definitely frightened. This is a board state that can make us die. About it. Here they go. Metamorphose. And Lava Dart. Yeah. and mutagenic growth, and hits us for 6. Well, we'll take it. There's a demon. Well, play a land, play Poet's Quill, tutor up a Pest Summonings. All right, so what's our plan? Yeah, let's just Poet's Quill, equip, go to combat, hit ya. Well, this is gonna be interesting. Pony goes to 9. We'll see how many spells they have. Pony did not play a land. Okay, there's a land. They can't flash back their Lava Dart yet, which is kind of helpful. Remember, too, we're probably going to need 6 life for this demon. All right, another Nivmegas. That's better than a spell. What we're really hoping for is a land. Our dream scenario is draw an untap land, Pest Summonings, sack everything, demon, and give it life. Okay. All right, so we're taking 9. That's a lot. Yeah. Well, we shall see. We drop to 7. We draw the land. Oh, I think we got to go for it. So we play the land. We go to combat. We hit you with the Lancet Tap Reaver. It's going to come down to what our opponent top decks here, if anything. Gain a couple life. Well, 10-10 Flying Treble Lifelink. Is it enough? So, opponent goes to 7. We go to 9. We play Pest Summonings to give us some more creatures. We Demon at Death Gate, sacking everything. Go down to 3, up to 5. Get a demon. Lifelink it. And pass the turn. All right. What do you find, opponent? Opponent, Desperation Sack of Sunbait Canyon. And, dead? Maybe? Crash through for trample. That doesn't change things, though, because we have a 10-10 lifelinker. Oh, it's gonna work. Lifelinking demon, our lesson plan paying off! Yes! Oh, that's so sweet. That is so sweet. Yeah, it's game. Opponent not giving up. Monastery Swift Spear. This still doesn't matter, though. Opponent. Big swing. Well, we will big block. Go up to 10. More tap lands. Untap. Attack. And, whew, well, that was our learned lesson plan being optimal. All right. Sideboarding-wise, we don't really have much. Could bring in an Angrass Rampage just to have more removal, but really, I mean, we basically want to do what we did last game. Let's go down to Village Rites for a Rampage and just run it like that. Opponent's on the play! Okay, this hand's not bad. We're going to need another creature at some point, but we can answer the first dork. We have 2-1 drops. If they kill Eyetwitch, we can get a Pest Summonings, and Awaken the Blood Avatar does seem decent in this matchup. About it. Lumimancer on the mulligan. Well, we got an answer. Foreboding Ruins, coming into play, untap for woods. Kill the Lumimancer, go. That is the hard part about the Lumimancer deck. Incredibly explosive and powerful. Also a little rough against removal. We're not even really that heavy of We're not even really that heavy of a removal deck, but if you can keep the threats off the battlefield, goes much better. Well, 2-1 drops. If our 1 drops live, and we draw another one, we can awaken next turn. Ooh, Light Scribe. All right, 1 drop. Oh, it'd be so good. It would be so good. Yes! Dreams are lived! This is why we're playing the deck. Red, black. Oh, this is so good. This might just win the game. Sag them all. Learn. Get rid of the Light Scribe. Hit you for 6. We'll take a Pest Summonings. Opponent has to sacrifice. Well, here comes Avatar. Hit you for 6. Oh, so good. So good. Opponent down to 10. All right, opponent. So our opponent could have brought in paths after sideboarding, but they need an answer. And I mean, we do have a Pest Summoning, so we can rebuild. We also have a bunch of things we can play from the graveyard. About it. Down to 9. Oh, they have the most painful mana bases. Sunbaked Canyon, great. Not great as your only lands, opponent. Redraws, double red. Are you dead? What do you say, opponent? Swift Spear, okay. Well, that does give our opponent chump blockers. Not especially worried about dying to them, especially with Pest Summonings in hand. Swift Spear is the hardest threat. Wow, opponent's just going for it, okay. Our opponent may have just given up here. The problem for our opponent is, once we attack with this Avatar, they go to 2, which actually turns off their mana. So opponent goes to 2. Can only tap one of their lands. We will teach them a lesson. Do a little pestin. About it. Done? Are we done? Oh, this deck's working. It's working shockingly well. Opponent, down to 1. Path, okay, they found the path. Yeah, okay, that's fine. We will grab a swamp. But our opponent has to not take a damage for the rest of the game. And draw lands to be even able to cast anything. So opponent can't attack or they're literally dead. And opponent scoops them up. And yeah, not bad, not bad. The path, the learned lesson pest plan actually kind of works. Wow. All right. Well, sweet, sweet, sweet. So what do we learn this week about demonic learning in Modern? And the deck actually kind of crushed it. We went 4-1. Our one loss came to this, I don't even know, Yarion Tron Gifts Eldrazi? I don't even know what to describe that deck as, but it was a deck that was Gifts Ungivening for Burial Rites in Elish Norn, which is kind of just unbeatable for our deck if our opponent can pull that off. So that match did not go well. Otherwise, we beat Esper Control. We beat Jund, like usual. Poor Jund cannot even beat Lessons and Learn an Eyetwitch in Modern. Eldrazi Tron, we took down. Clever Boros Aggro. So we got a pretty good mixture of decks from Control to Midrange to Aggro. And Demonic Learning was competitive with all of them. So, of course, the main thing we learned is that Demon Adeskate and the plan of getting on the battlefield on turn 2, and to a lesser extent, Awaken the Blood Avatar, are actually pretty insane in Modern. A little bit matchup dependent. We saw, like, Esper Control. We were very nervous about just sacking our board to Demon Adeskate, trying to wait until we could, like, find it to rest, because the nightmare is we sack all of our stuff, Demon Adeskate, spend 6 life, and our opponent's like, oh, Path to Exile, or to Fairy Bounce, or something. And then things go really poorly, but in a lot of matchups, like Eldrazi Tron, what are they going to do? How are they going to kill a 9-9 on turn 2? Or Clever Boros, like, what is Boros Aggro going to do? That's 3 lightning bolts? What are the odds that they have 3 lightning bolts to kill a demon? And if they spend their entire hand of lightning bolts to kill a demon, we're probably winning anyway. So the plan of getting Demon Adeskate and Waken the Blood Avatar on the battlefield early worked really, really well. On the other hand, I was honestly pretty surprised at the lesson plan. Like, the lesson and learning package actually worked pretty well. Eyetwitch was good. We had a Poet's Quill game where the lifelink from Poet's Quill was able to win us the match against the Clever Boros deck. Like, we would have lost that game if we did not have access to Poet's Quill to put on our demon. So that was really key. I think that the package, I don't know. I still don't think it's good enough that you want to just slot it into any deck. I think you need a specific purpose. And I think our deck is a deck that has a specific purpose. We want sackable one drops for Awaken the Blood Avatar and Demon the Deskgate. So that helps with Eyetwitch. We naturally want cards like Eyetwitch in our deck, and then we can take advantage of Pest Summonings in specific to refuel our board, have a buffer for, like, Edict effects. We saw that being important against Jund, where we Demon, and our opponent could theoretically just, like, Liliana it away, but if we can have a Pest sitting around, that helps protect us from that. Plus, the Pest Summonings helps prepare us for our second Avatar Demon, where we can sack our board, tutor up a Pest Summonings. That's 2 more creatures on the battlefield that happen to be black creatures, which is kind of unique for tokens. Not a ton of black token production in efficient form like Pest Summonings. So we can sack everything, get a Pest Summonings, and that gets us 2/3 of the way there to another Awaken the Blood Avatar or another Demon Adeskate. So it's a great way to rebuild. We never really use Necrotic Fumes. I'm sure it would come up, like the Eldrazi Tron matchup. We kind of just killed them with a demon. But if that game actually went long, I could certainly imagine getting a Necrotic Fumes to deal with a Thought Not Seer or something like that. And Start From Scratch, that's probably our least powerful lesson in a vacuum. However, it's actually really nice as a toolbox card, because one of the things that would be really good against our deck would be something like Ensnaring Bridge. So even though Start From Scratch is the lesson that we're going to tutor for least, I would say, in the games when we do get it and it, like, snags an Ensnaring Bridge that our opponent tutor up with Karn or whatever, having that in our sideboard And being able to access it in game one thanks to Eyetwitch and Poet's Quill and Hunt for Specimens is actually just game winning. So it does cost a sideboard slot. It is overcosted for sure compared to other ways of dealing with an artifact in Modern, but the upside of grabbing it in game one when we sack our Eyetwitch is really huge, so the deck actually felt good. Oh yeah, the other thing I didn't mention is the backup plan of just playing recursive one drops actually can get there against control decks. Like against control decks that are trying to use Wrath and Planeswalkers to control the board, just going like Bloodsoaked Champion into Gutterbones Dreadwanderer, attack you, you like remove our stuff and we take and sacrifice it or get it back from the graveyard and just keep attacking you with these weird recursive Savannah Lions, that's a plan that can actually get there in some matchups as well. So I really like this deck. The deck is sweet, it takes advantage of new cards, it's making the lesson plan actually kind of work in Modern, so I don't know. If you're looking for something new to try in Modern out of budget, I would definitely recommend it. We've had a couple of really good budgets Modern decks recently. I really like the Dina deck from last week as well, so check that one out if you haven't already. Anyway, that has been our budget magic for this week. Demonic Learning for Modern. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed watching Judd not be able to beat an Eyetwitch, and I will talk to you soon.
Thanks for watching the video. If you enjoyed it, help us out by clicking that like button down below. And to keep up on all the latest and greatest, click that subscribe button. And don't forget to hit that bell icon to get alerts whenever we have new videos. And if you want to, check out some of our other sweet videos here and here.